Thank you. We ask that you take over this place. Invade our hearts right now. Invade our hearts again. Let the fire of the Spirit remain in us, O Father God. Thank you, Lord. The Holy Spirit is in here in this place. Thank you, Holy Spirit, because you're hovering in this entire building of Father God. Even your Spirit, Lord God, is taking over this place. We just want to surrender ourselves before you, God. And we ask for the touch of heaven. Let the touch of heaven, Lord God, be upon this place, O God. We reach out to you. We want the touch of heaven. We thank you, Lord. Let's sing that song again, the touch of heaven. Jesus Christ. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Let's give the Lord a big hand.
Thank you, worship team.
Good afternoon, brothers and sisters, and those who are watching online also. So, it is giving time and praying that everybody is excited in giving his or her tithes and offerings. Because when God gave his first son and only begotten son as a sacrifice for our sins, he gave his first and best. So God deserves also what is best for him, and nothing less than the 10% of our income, which is our tithes. As in Matthew 22 verse 21, Jesus said to them, "So give back to Caesar what is Caesar's, and to God what is God's." The church is trying to help you understand the principle of tithing for your own benefit. Not for the church to get your money, but it's whether you understand that the tithes really belong to God. As in Leviticus 27 verse 30 says, "A tithe of everything from the land, whether grain from the soil or fruit from the trees, belong to God, and it is holy to the Lord." If we don't give our tithes, we are robbing God. As in Malachi 3:8, "Will a mere mortal rob God?" God said, "Yes, you rob me. But you ask, how are we robbing you? In tithes and offerings." So that we will not be robbing God, then we will give our 10% to the Lord or our tithes. And if we give our tithes or offerings, don't just tithe, but tithe in faith. Do it believing that God will open the windows of heaven over our life, as in Malachi 3:10. And that he will rebuke the devourer for our sake, as in Malachi 3:11. So let us pray. Heavenly Father, we praise and thank you for all the blessings, the favor, and the protection that you have given us. We pray, Lord, that you give us the grace and joy, love, and peace in giving our tithes and offerings, believing by faith that in you, every aspect of our lives will prosper. In Jesus' name, amen. Okay, so if we are going to give our tithes or offerings, we can do it by e-transfer, addressing to shekinahvictorychurch@gmail.com. And if it is by check, we can have our Southside Victory Church Fellowship as our paying name. Then if you have any question, please contact Ms. Cecil Esguerra. The number is not already there, so you can just email her. Okay, so may I have the offering confession front slide? Okay, so we sow our finances into the kingdom of God. Every dollar will produce for God and for us. Lives will be changed, bodies will be healed, and Satan will be stopped. It will produce for us a good measure, pressed down, shaken together, and running over, will God give back to us that we may give again. We come to this God in Jesus' name. Amen.
Thank you.
Okay, in addition to the offering a while ago, if you guys have any inquiries, just contact us at shekinahvictorychurch@gmail.com. Yes. Thank you. So here are the reminders and some changes in our schedule. So virtual study, so still continues throughout the week. There is one simple change on it. So discipleship level 1 will be on Tuesday now instead of Thursday. So if you guys are new, join this one. It will be led by Cecil and Tita Cora. If you've done that already, you can also join the discipleship level 2 led by Kuya Chris and Ata Lorraine. And same thing, Tuesday as well. If you guys are a couple or are married, you can also join the Wednesday Couples Bible Study by Pastor Adina and Pastor Fred. And on Thursday, it will be Discipleship Level 2 by Ate Apen and Kuya Manny. Volunteers. So we're still seeking volunteers. Hopefully, we will be back soon. And we're expecting more people. So we are also seeking for more volunteers. So if you guys are interested, please contact Ate Apet or Tita Cora on this one. Church service will be online for the next few weeks. I think hopefully it will be lifted this week or next week, so everybody can come back to church. And check our Facebook page for more information. Mask as well. So for those who are in church, we encourage everybody to wear their mask. And thank you so much. Welcome to church.
This will be our last Sunday together. This will be our last Sunday that we will be online. So I just declare that this coming Sunday, all of you will be here, okay, the next Sunday. So I have a word, which is very unusual actually, because today is a very special Sunday. Today is a day of Pentecost, okay? And the Pentecost is after 50 days when Jesus went to heaven, after 50 days of his resurrection, okay? So I'm so blessed. Sorry for our hello. Okay, now we know that the problem. So okay, so today is a Pentecost day, and this is a very special day for all the Christians around the world, because you know why? Jesus went to heaven, but he never left us as orphan. Okay? He sent us the Holy Spirit, and the Holy Spirit is the one who empowers us. So before I will start, I need to pray first. Okay, Father Lord, I just want to thank you for today. Lord, thank you, Father, Lord God, that you are touching the heart of the people today. Thank you, Holy Spirit, Lord God. Father, Lord God, it's not by might nor by power, but by the Spirit of the living God. And I thank you, Father, Lord God, that something good is going to happen today as I share the word that you put into my heart, Lord God. Father, Lord God, there will be a revival into our heart, Lord. There will be breakthrough that will come into our families and to our children and to our finances, Lord God, and to our marriages, Lord God. Lord, you are not a God, a stagnant God. You always want us to go to the next level. So thank you, God. Father, possess me, Holy Spirit, more of you, Lord God. I thank you, Jesus, Lord God, that today is the day, Lord God, that you're going to show yourself strong. You're going to show yourself, Lord God, that you are still working. You show yourself, Lord God, that you are still faithful, God. And we bless you, Holy Spirit. Thank you for possessing me in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. So what I'm going to share today is about the Pentecost Sunday, okay? Because I believe that we are celebrating Christmas, we are celebrating the death of Jesus, but do you know that it is very important also to remember that Jesus, when he went to heaven, okay, with the undeniable witnesses that he raised from dead to life, okay? That he told his disciples that before you will go up and proclaim the word of God and disciple the nation, before you go out and preach the word of God, okay, to the whole nations, okay, I want you to stay first in one place and wait for the Holy Spirit to come unto you, okay? And before I will speak about these things, I don't know why God led me, that's why I told you, it's a quite unusual Holy Spirit preaching. But I want us to read in the book of 1 Kings chapter 18, because there's something in the Old Testament, okay? The Old Testament, we have a new covenant and we have an old covenant, but it doesn't mean that we are going to disregard the old covenant, because that's where we can see the heart of God, the principle of God, the ways of God, okay? What can we learn from their mistake? Okay, because it was during the time that it was King Ahab, okay? King Ahab is the one who was the king of Israel during the time. And King Ahab, if you know that, the history of his, when he reigned in Israel, okay? He was one of the most wicked king, okay? He was so wicked that there is no even, there is no comparison. Like Solomon is the wisest king, but King Ahab is the most wicked king, okay? Because King Ahab married Jezebel. Okay, Jezebel is a princess from other countries that worship Baal. Okay, that worship the false god, and she brought her prophet. She brought her god in Israel, and what's that? And influenced the Israelites to worship Baal. So this is the season that the king. That God was so like that displeased, okay? He was not really happy during the time of Ahab, is because Jezebel brought the bad influence, the ungodly influence, and this is not just local, this is national level, okay? The whole nation of Israel really started worshiping Baal, okay? Worshiping the false god, worshiping the god that is not true, because our God is a jealous God. So I'm going to share it to you before I'm going to the books of Acts, how God wants to empower us, okay? What can we learn from this story, okay? So during the time when the Israelites are what's that, confused, during this time in the reign of what's that, Ahab, the Israelites never served the Lord full-heartedly. Their other feet in the foot is in the other side, okay, in God, and then the other foot is in the world, okay? They don't have any more godly fear during that time because of the influence of Jezebel, okay? In fact, the government is enticing them to worship Baal. The government is enticing them, okay, to don't serve the living God of Israel. And do you know that this is also relevant in this season? During the time of Ahab, the Lord put it into my heart. I said, God, why you want me to share this one? It's because during the time of Ahab, it seems that this is also a time that we will never, like the media, okay, the government or the people, okay, they never anymore have the fear of God. We are worshiping God at the same time. We have our own God in Monday, we have our own God in Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, and then Sunday we go to the living God. Okay, so we are in a compromising situation. And that was exactly what happened during the time of King Ahab, okay? That people serve the Lord. People, they know that there is a God of Israel who saved them from Egypt, okay, from Pharaoh, but yet they started worshiping the false god. They started having a wife, but still they are having their girlfriend. They started being corrupt. They started really like, it's okay for them to have sex without marriage. And just like, this is what happened during the time of King Ahab, during the time of this Queen Jezebel that is very wicked. And they corrupt, the government is corrupt, and nobody is anymore being honest, and people has no fear in the living God. And do you know that God loves us so much? Do you know that God is a merciful God? Do you know that God has a good plan for our country, for our nation, even Philippines and Canada, because God will never give up on us. Even the people during the time of Ahab, the people never served the Lord. They worship this false God. They never even have the fear for the Lord. They never even have they never teach their children about Ten Commandments. They never really like have the heart to honor the God of Israel. Okay, they forget about who is the real God. They serve so many gods. They are just like on the fence, okay? That they are not in the other side and they are not in the other side. They are at the middle. They are confused what to do in their life, okay? They live a defeated life. And you know, because of that, God, so like withheld the rain. There is no more rain for 3.5 years. Because you know why? You cannot expect the blessing of the Lord to come into our life if God is not pleased with us. I'm just being honest with you. Of course, there is grace. The grace is so powerful. By God's grace, by God's mercy, God will still give us the favor and the blessing. But you know what? So many of us, okay, around the world are suffering now. And you know what? God is not really surprised with these things that's going on. Okay? Because God knows from the start and the beginning. So this is what happened, because God has a good plan for the nation of Israel. Even if the Israelites people during the time of Ahab, they never worshiped the living God. They live an unrighteous life. They live a life that is displeasing to the Lord. Okay? But yet, God touched the heart of Elijah. And this is what Elijah challenged Ahab. Said, okay, I want you to go to Mount Carmel and we are going to have a showdown. Who will be the real God? Wow. I just declare and decree that all of us here has this kind of spirit. Okay? He said, I want you to go up to Mount Carmel and we are going to have a showdown. Who will be the real God? The God of Baal, your God of Jezebel, or the God of Israel? So all the people, they said, all the people, okay, went there to Mount Carmel. And this morning, I just like, wow, God, why the showdown is in the mountain? Okay, why the showdown, not who is the real God? The battle is in the mountain top, okay? And the Lord, I don't know why, it just came into my mind, okay, that do you know that there is a battle in the seven mountains now? Okay, like Lance Walnut said, that what is that? The family mountain, the religion mountain, the entertainment mountain, art and entertainment mountain, the media mountain, there's a battle there. Politics mountain, business mountain, okay, the government mountain, there is a battle there, okay? It's because Jesus is coming soon. So that's why they made the battle in the top of Mount Bethel, okay? So they went, Mount Carmel, so they went there. And then, okay, I'm just going to like this one, okay, this is very powerful. And Elijah came to all the people and said, how long will you falter between two opinions? Or how long are you going to waver with your faith? Because God has a good plan for us. God has a good plan for our nation. How long are you going to be deceived by the God of this world? Okay, that is what Elijah said, because he was full with the Holy Spirit. And how long will you falter between two opinions? How long are you going to waver? Because you know, like waver. Because God said, even in what's that in Revelation, okay, chapter 3, verse 16, that if you are cold or hot, I will spit you up. If you are not cold or either hot, okay? So God will spit it up. This is now a New Testament, okay? So because you are lukewarm, never hot nor cold, I am about to spit you out of my mouth. And this is the situation during the time of Ahab, as he was the king, a wicked king of Israel. So what happened? Go back there, translate to 1 Kings chapter 18. Okay? If the Lord is God, follow him. Okay? If the Lord, the God of Israel, if he is the real God, follow him. But he said, follow him. But if Baal, follow him. But the people answered him not a word. And I was so amazed with this. I said, God, that how deceived the people were. They never ever answered the word because they don't know what is right or what is wrong. They don't know already if this is from the Lord or if this is from the enemy. They don't know already if this sin is really sin, or this is like it's okay to stay together, it's okay to tell a lie, it's okay to live an unrighteous life and believing that by God's grace you can still go to heaven. This is really the situation during the time, and I believe that this is so relevant right now. So many teenagers, they don't even know anymore that what is right or wrong, because their mindset is so polluted with the Hollywood doctrine, okay? And this is a season that we need to really make it sure that we are going to know what is right and wrong, what is righteous, what is holy, and what is ungodly, because God wants us to have a revival in our nation, a revival in our family. But if we are not going to make up our mind, God will speak it out, and that is not my word, that is the word of God, okay? And so it said, but the people answered, okay? So what did happen to it? Therefore, let them give us two bulls, okay? Because they want to offer a sacrifice to the Lord there in the mountaintop, okay? And let them choose one bull for themselves, cut it in pieces and lay it on the wood. But put no fire under it, and I will prepare the other bull and lay it on the wood, but put no fire under it. So this will be the showdown now, okay, in the mountaintop. And all the people of Israel went to the mountaintop. They said, it's all, okay? I just like laying it on the word of God. Plus, the 450 false prophets, the prophet of Baal, okay, they went there as well. And there's two altars, okay? One altar of Baal and one altar of the living God. And then Elisha said, okay, though the God that will give us the fire, the God that will give us the supernatural fire, because he said, there is no fire there, there is no matches, there is no lighter there. But whose God who can give us the fire is the true God, because he wants to show it to the people of Israel that the God of Israel is more powerful than the God of this world, okay? And this is what happened. Okay, then you call on the name of your God, and I will call on the name of the Lord, and the God who answered by fire, he is God. Wow, thank you, Lord, that our God is a consuming fire, okay? Our God is a consuming fire. That is really the promise of the Lord. Yeah, for God is a consuming fire. Hebrews chapter 12, verse 29. Thank you, Franceline. This is really God. Our God is a consuming fire. Do you know there's something happened with the fire? Because during the time of Moses, God lead them. The pillar of fire is representing the presence of the Lord. And until now, the fire is still working. It's the same fire during the time of Moses. It's the same fire during the time of Elijah. It's the same fire that God wants to touch us today. Are you agree with that? Say amen. Amen. So then all the, and then you call on the name of the Lord. Okay, next answer, friend's life. And it came to pass at the time of the offering of the evening sacrifice that Elijah, the prophet, came near and said, Lord God of Abraham, before this one. So the prophet, the 450 prophet of Baal, if you read it in this chapter, they keep on, they did their ritual already, and then they even like make their skin like blood coming out, and they worship the living, their gods, but no fire at all. And even Elijah said, mock them, like maybe your God went for holiday, maybe your God is asleep. Like you need to make noise more. But still, there is no fire. And then now is Elijah's turn, okay? Elijah said, okay, now it's my turn. Maybe about 4 o'clock already, they started in the morning. Maybe 4 o'clock or 6 o'clock in the evening already, because we give them a chance to know, so that all the people of Israel, they will know that who is the real God. And so, this is what happened. And it came to pass at the time of the offering of the evening, so it's already evening sacrifice, that Elijah the prophet came near and said, Lord God of Abraham, Isaac, and Israel, let it be known this day that you are God in Israel, that I am your servant, and that I have done all these things at your word. Okay. Hear me, O Lord, hear me, that these people may know that you are the Lord God, and that you have turned their hearts back to you again. So imagine, this is the mercy of the Lord. God will use the prophet to tell us that we need to turn our heart back to the Lord again. Okay? Then the fire of the Lord fell and consumed the burnt sacrifice and the wood and the stones and the dust, and it licked up the water that was in the trench. So the fire of the Lord came, and I just declare and decree that today, the fire of the Lord will come into our heart today to be ignited, so that we will do it again in life, okay? And then, now when all the people saw it, they fell on their faces. I'm just so emotional with this, because this is what happened today. The people who are listening right now in the camera, that God's fire will touch to you today in the mighty name of Jesus, God. Now when all the people saw it, they fell on their faces and they said, the Lord, he is God. The Lord, he is God. And it took the fire of God to come, so that their scale, their eyes will be opened. the people during that time were so deceived with unrighteousness. They thought that it is good to do all these things. Okay, as long as it's good, we don't hurt other people, I can do anything I want. And that is not godly. They were so deceived by the God of this world. And do you know that until now, it's still the same. So many Christians have been deceived because they lost the fire of the living God. They lost the fire to love the Lord. There is no more zeal. There is no more heart. There is no more excitement. There is no more passion. Because the fire already dwindled and they didn't understand why they cannot do it anymore, living a righteous life, because the fire already has quenched by the devil, by watching all these things, by listening to the false prophet. I hope you understand this one. And you know what happened? I said, God, as I studied this lesson, Lord, I will never be deceived. I will never worship Baal. And the Lord reminded me, I don't know, it's not, I never heard God. You know, Dina, because when I read the Old Testament before, I read a lot of Old Testament before. Okay, until now I keep on reading. But I said, God, why the Israelites always be deceived by the devil? Like, don't worship Baal, don't worship all these false gods, but they still do that. And the Lord put it into my heart, you know, Dina, until now, my people has been deceived. And I said, God, why, Lord? It's because they never get the fire of the Holy Spirit. Because it takes fire for us to live a righteous, victorious life. It takes the fire of the living God. And it's just like, I was so shocked when last year, okay, we have been praying for a new place, this place. We have been praying for a new building, and all the core group are really like okay, calling the people, calling these churches, and I keep on calling also. And every time I call for a place to worship, okay, I call the churches, I call the pastor, and they always ask me that, what is your position in gay marriages? I said, we don't want people to look down on them. We agree with that kind of principle. And these are the pastors. I'm talking to the pastors. And I just, Lord, what's going on? These people are doctorate in the Word of God. They read the Word of God. They study the Word of God. And I just like, God, what's going on, Lord? Why they don't know? How come they don't know what is right or wrong anymore? And they are convincing me. They are angry with the people who disagree with their belief. And yet, they are pastors. They are leaders of the church. And one time, I talked to these people, to this pastor. He's so nice. Now, I love this pastor. And I talked to him. And I said, okay, I already have the meeting with my board, and they allow you to rent our place. And in fact, I preached that place during the time of Women's International Conference, okay? And that pastor is so nice, and Dina, I like you, and they already allow us to rent that place. I said, okay. So I told to the pastor, what are the something like conditions? I said, I'm going to email you the condition. This is the condition. When I read it, I was crying. You know why? It's because they said, you need to agree with this kind of marriages, which is anti-biblical. And then he said, you cannot preach prosperity in this church. As long as you are renting here, no prosperity preaching in the church. You cannot preach any prosperity. And don't preach about healing, because we don't believe about healing anymore. If you want to rent this place, you need to get a sign that you agree with us, that this is our principle. And so many things that so unloving. I was crying. It's because he is a pastor. I was crying because these people, they live the Word of God. They study the Word of God, but there is no more fire in their heart. They have been deceived. So don't ever trust yourself that you will not be deceived if without the fire of the living God, because the fire is the one. When the people saw the fire came during the time of Elijah, they said, okay, the Lord our God, He is our God, the God of Israel, the Lord our God. And you know what happened? If we are going not to desire the fire of the Holy Spirit into our life, even if you go to church, you will still be deceived, because right now the devil is working overtime. But thank God, God is giving us the Holy Spirit. God is giving us the gift of the Holy Spirit, that God said, I will and so many people believe that grace, they just do things and grace will cover them. I don't know about it, but one thing I know, that God said, live a holy life. And you cannot do that without the fire of the living God. So that's why Jesus said to his disciple in Acts chapter 1 verse 8, because only the Spirit, the fire of the living God, that can help us. You know why? If you don't have the fire of the living God, you will think that what is right, it become wrong. And you will think what is wrong, it will become right. Do you know that? Without the fire of the living God, you don't have discernment. Without the fire of the living God, you don't know that that friend is not really for you. You don't know if without the fire of the living God, you will make ungodly decision in your life. Without the fire of the living God, you don't even know if your heart still in tune with Jesus, because only the fire, imagine that. During the time of Elijah, people live an unrighteous life and they didn't know that. Moses gave them the law. Moses gave them the word of God, and they don't even understand anymore because their eyes were so blinded. But when the fire of the living God came, they know already what to do and what they did during the time. In 1 Kings chapter 18, but you shall, 1 Kings chapter 18, first translate, because this is just like in my thought right now. This is what they did. Okay. And when all the people saw it, they fell on their faces and they said, the Lord, He is God. The Lord, He is God. Is it somewhere there? And Elijah said to them, seize the prophets of Baal. Do not let one of them escape. So they seized them. And Elijah brought them down to the brook Kishon and executed them there. The people, they worship Baal. They honored the false prophet. They supported the false prophet. But then during the time when the fire of God came, they helped to seize. They killed all the prophets. And I believe this is a season for us that we are going to kill the false prophet into our life. Seize off all the things that is not from the Lord. Seize off, because we are the gatekeeper of our ears. We are the gatekeepers of our eyes. We are the gatekeeper of our mouth. We need to seize it. We need to kill everything that is not from the Lord. But it's not by might, but it's not by power, but by the Spirit of the living God. It takes the fire of God to do it, because we cannot do it without the grace of the living God. I hope you're blessed with that. And even in fact, in first, in Acts 1:8, because this is what God has promised to us. But you shall receive power when the Holy Spirit has come upon you, and you shall be witnesses to me in Jerusalem and in all Judea and Samaria and to the end of the earth. You see, our serving with the Lord, Christianity is not about religion. Christianity is about power. Christianity is not religion. How come? God said that if any man be in church, no. God never said if any man be in church, he is a new creation. If any man be in Christ, he is a new creation. Behold, all things has passed away and the new things has come. So I don't want to get lesser. I want the best that God can give it to us. Why settle for less if God will give us the best? Why we are contented living a life that is always defeated? Well, God can give us the victory by the power of the Holy Spirit. Because in Matthew chapter 3 verse 11, in fact, this is John the Baptist, okay? That baptizing there in Jordan River, but John the Baptist said, I indeed baptize you with water and to repentance, but he who is coming after me is mightier than I, whose sandals I am not worthy to carry. He will baptize you with the Holy Spirit and fire. This is the same fire, because God will never change. It's the same yesterday, today, and forever. The same fire, because his power will not be diminished. He is an immutable God. He will not progress, because he is all powerful, almighty, all incredible. Okay, he's everything. It's the same fire that the Holy Spirit said, God, Jesus will come here to us, and He's going to baptize us with the Holy Spirit and with fire. With fire, with fire, with fire. So I just release right now the fire of the living God to all the people who are here and watching in the internet, because only the fire of the living God can give us the real victory in the mighty name of Jesus. I just prophesy all to you that fire will come to you, because you know why? If you don't have the fire of the living God, you will live a defeated life. If you have fire, if you don't have the fire of the living God, you will live a very depressed person. This is the season to have the fire of the living God. So many bad news out there. But you know what? God really is not bothered with that. Do you know God is not bothered with that going on in coronavirus? When 2013, I was half asleep in the morning, and God told me, I don't know, no, I just read it, Corona crown. I was half asleep, okay? And then I just woke up, I went to the washroom. He said, God told me it's crown. I said, Lord, what do you mean by crown? Because I was half asleep. And then suddenly, yes, Corona. God said, I have the crown. And you know, God is not worried about this coronavirus. God is not worried about this crisis. God is not worried about what's going on around the world. Why is worry? He's God, He's sovereign. God is concerned only to His people who doesn't know who they are. God is concerned to the people who doesn't know that they have the power of the Holy Spirit, the fire of the Holy Spirit upon them. We forgot who we are as church. God is concerned. Do you know who you are? You are powerful. You are the solution of the problem. You are victorious. You are so dangerous to the kingdom of darkness. That's God is concerned. He's not concerned about coronavirus. He's not concerned so many people are dead. He's not concerned with that, because He knows that the Lord already told us that I give you already the Holy Spirit. I give you already the fire of the living God. Why should I concern? You have the power. You have the authority to trample the enemy, and no harm will come upon you. God is concerned because the church is sleeping. We don't know that God told us that you are the solution of this. You have the power, you have the authority, and I'm counting on you, church, to do it. But you do it according to the power of the Holy Spirit, by the fire of the living God. I hope you understand this one, because it hurt me so much to watch my people living a defeated life. We are not supposed to be that way. God doesn't mind about all these things that's going on. He's just minding us. We don't know who we are, because we don't have the fire of the living God in us. We need to have the fire, because you know why? In the day of Pentecost, in Acts chapter 2, and this is so powerful, that's why today is a very powerful Sunday. When the day of Pentecost had fully come, because they waited there for 10 days in that place, they were all with one accord in one place. Do you know, unity is very important. God will not really give the fullest destiny of a church or a family if there is no unity. So we need to be united, and we need to be united with the Holy Spirit. And suddenly there came a sound from heaven as of a rushing mighty wind. Do you know, if there is fire, there is wind as well. And it filled the whole house where they were sitting. Then there appeared to them divided tongues as the fire, as a fire. So the fire then came, and one sat upon each of them, and they were all filled with the Holy Spirit and began to speak with other tongues, and the Spirit gave them utterance. So God said, now I give you already the power of the Holy Spirit. The fire is upon us right now. I just declare and decree that the Holy Spirit, the fire of the Holy Spirit, will upon us right now to empower others as well. Because you know what? If we don't have the fire of the Holy Spirit, we don't have passion. We don't have excitement, you know. But if you have the fire of the Holy Spirit upon you, nobody will encourage you. You will read your Bible. If you have the Holy Spirit upon you, the fire of the Holy Spirit upon you, nobody will encourage you. You will go to church. You will worship the living God. Nobody will encourage you, because the fire is burning inside you. It's just like a living water that's flowing from your belly, because you are full of love. You are full of the Holy Spirit, and you can do it only by speaking in tongues, because this is the weapon that God is giving to us. Why should settle for less? If God will give us this weapon, then we are going to use it. This is our anything. We need to have the zeal of the Holy Spirit for us to live a victorious life. And I want you to know these things, because I just declare and decree that none of us here will be deceived, because all of us have the fire of the Holy Spirit. Shekinah den nekinisho. Yakara santa kada shonda kada ba. Hamba kada shonda kada tuka kada shikiro pa kada shonda kada ba. Yakara danta kada shuka kada danta kada buka kada shia. Hakara danta kada ba. Hakara siki di buka kada buka kada shendi kidi ya. Hakara danta kada ba 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 ba. Fire of the living God, fall afresh on us, Lord God. Fire of the living God, come, come, Holy Spirit, and empower us as you did during the time of Elijah, Lord God. The people has been deceived, but the moment the fire of the living God came, they know that the spirit of being deceived has been broken. So, Lord God, as the sound of my voice, Lord God, use me as Elijah, Lord God, that God, as Lord God, I speak right now, God, that the fear of the Lord will rest upon the people who are listening right now in the mighty name of Jesus, God. I'm possessed with the Holy Spirit right now. Don't criticize me. Yakara shintiki disho. Hapaka da shintiki disho kara takadaba. Hapaka da shinta. I speak right now victory to all of you here who are listening at the sound of my voice. The spirit of darkness will be broken in the mighty name of Jesus. As the sound of my voice, the spiritual zeal will come and the fire of God will be ignited into my people, will be ignited into the kurgum, will be ignited to the people who are listening right now, by families, by families, by families, because the fire is here in the mighty name of Jesus, God. And the Lord put it into my heart. The only way for us to do that, we need to have a self-surrender to the Lord. Surrender. Don't just surrender your time. Don't just surrender your money. Don't just surrender your mind, but surrender yourself. God wants us, not just our time, not just our money, not just our talent, not just our mind. God said, I want you. I want your heart. I want your love. I want your everything. Surrender it unto me, because that is the only way for us that the fire of the living God will be ignited into our spirit, and it will flow like a river that is unstoppable, that wherever you go, you will bring the fire of the living God. And people will ask you, what's with you? How come you are very attracted? How come you are not afraid? How come I can feel that there is joy in your heart? You didn't hear the word, you didn't hear the news of CNN, you didn't hear how many people died in COVID, but said, no, my case is different, because I have the fire of the living God in my heart, because I love Jesus. I hope you understand this one. 2011, I keep on speaking in tongues in the house. I don't even want to talk to my friends anymore. I'm just so addicted with the presence of the Lord. And you know, in my early marriage, I cried a lot. I cried a lot with my husband. I cried a lot in the church. I cried a lot. I cried a lot. During the time, it was 2011. At the middle, no, 3 o'clock, I almost couldn't breathe. I just don't know why. I almost couldn't breathe. And I woke up with that. I said, what's happening to my heart, Lord? You said my heart was swollen. And the Lord put it into my heart. I'm putting the joy in your heart. I'm putting the joy. I said, God, is there any in the Bible with that? I'm putting that. Jesus told me, Vita, I'm putting the joy in your heart. And I was so joyful. It's unspeakable joy. Joy, unspeakable joy. And I just reminded, that reminded me that in Romans chapter 14, verse 17, that the kingdom of God is not meat or drink, but righteousness, peace, and joy in the Holy Ghost. In the Holy Ghost, the kingdom of God is not meat or drink, but righteousness, peace, and joy in the Holy Ghost. So if you are going to keep on desiring God in your life, it is really very good, because joy, the kingdom of God is not meat or drink. It's not about all these material things. It's not about all this mammon. It's not about all this flesh. It's not about all these things, because whatsoever, like God said in his word, that whatsoever is not like if you gain the whole world but forfeited your own soul, it's nothing. is nothing. But God will give you peace, love, and joy because you are communing with God. The Holy Ghost is upon you. Okay, like other people think, okay, Pastor Ron, if you receive Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, the Holy Ghost is with you. Yes, the Holy Ghost is with you. But it's different if the Holy Ghost is upon you. The Holy Ghost empower you. The Holy Ghost consume you. The Holy Ghost possess you. And you can only do it if you're going to use the language of speaking in tongues, because it is a weapon against the devil in this season. Because you know why? Speaking in tongues is a perfect prayer. In 1 Corinthians chapter 14, verse 2, for he who speaks in a tongue does not speak to men, but to God. But for no one understands him. However, in the spirit, he speaks mysteries. You see? For he who speaks in a tongue does not speak to men, but to God. For no one understands him. However, in the spirit, he speaks mysteries. So, speaking in tongues is a perfect prayer. Speaking in tongues, you let the Holy Spirit pray for you through your mouth, but it is not your own word, it's the Spirit that utters. It's the Holy Spirit, it's the speaking in tongues, it's a mystery. You know why? Because sometimes when we pray with our own word, sometimes we make mistake. But the Holy Spirit is a perfect prayer if we speak in tongues. And I'm telling you, this church was birthed. I spoke in tongues a lot. The core group spoke in tongues a lot. We didn't know that God would give us this place. But because we spoke in tongues, that was a perfect prayer and God gave us this place. The people who are coming here, those people who are listening, you are there. You are the answer of the speaking in tongues. Because there's power in speaking in tongues. Why wait for the problem to come into your life and then you speak in tongues? No, before the problem will come into your life, speak in tongues. And God will remove every wrong people into your life. God will give you wisdom that you don't know even that is really for you or not, because the Holy Spirit is a spirit of truth. The Holy Spirit is the spirit of truth. He will give you the real truth which no man will know about it. I hope you understand this one, because you know why? I really want us to win in life in this season. Shekinah, we always say it's a breakthrough church. Of course, it's a breakthrough church. But only by the power of the Holy Spirit. Only by the power of the fire of the Holy Ghost. If you have the fire of the Holy Ghost, you will never worry in life anymore. Because the fear of man will diminish into your life. Because the fire of God is a consuming fire. Imagine that. Everything that is not from the Lord into your life, it will be consumed. Do you know that you will know what is good and what is gold? Put it in the fire. And you will know. The gold will be purified more, but the wood will be diminished. And this is a season for us, I'm telling you. We need to be ablaze. We need to set our heart on fire for God. You need to lay hands on your head. Lord, set me on fire. It's because we cannot survive. We cannot win. We cannot be victorious if we only know God in salvation. Because God never just save us. God save us for more. So that you will be a blaze for God. Imagine that God said, if you are a blaze for me, you will be like a city at the top of the hill. Even if there's a city at the top of the hill, there is no light in that, you will don't know that that is a city. In fact, I see it in our big screen TV that I see it is a city, because you know, like there is like, I Google it, that there's a lot of fire, there's a lot of light in that city, and my husband said, oh, that's city, because and the rest is dark, okay? Because the reason why it's the top of the hill that you cannot be hidden because of the light of that. And you become the light of the world. You become the salt of the world. It's not just like we say we are going to heaven and then we leave hell here on earth and go to heaven. No, we live here on earth victorious. We live here on earth being the blessing, being the solution of the problem, living an abundant life. Okay? But we cannot do that without the fire of the living God. It takes the fire of the living God, because I was in this denomination. In fact, I honor my former church where I was growing up as a young girl. You know what? We love the Lord. We love His Word. We love to go to church, but we live a defeated life. You know why? Because we never practice the speaking in tongues. We never really take the gift that God gave to us. We don't want to take it all, but I'm greedy for God. I want to take it all. Lord, what is that that you died for me? I will take it all. Superimpose the Word of God into your life. Take it by force, because that is the way how God wants us to bless us. If you are only, if you just like, if God's will for me to prosper, if God's will for me to buy a house, if God's will for me to marry this man, if God's will for me to fulfill my destiny, then it's okay for me. But if not, it's okay for me. No, you need to take it by force. And I just declare to you that you are going to get what God has for you. 100%. There is no 90%. Ask big to the Lord. Ask big to the Holy Spirit. Lord, I want the Holy Spirit in a big way. I want the Holy Spirit, Lord God, in a mighty way. I want the Holy Spirit, Lord God, in a higher level, God. Because, Lord God, you can use me in a mighty way. You want God to use you in a mighty way, then ask God bigger in your authority, in your power, in your anointing. Because only by the anointing of the living God that you are going to be used by God in a powerful way. And you can only do that. Use the sword. Use the Word of God. And use the speaking in tongues, because it's a gift that God has given, is given to us, so that we may live a victorious life. Very important. The speaking in tongues in these days, very important. I want you. I told Jacob, I told my husband, speak in tongues every day. I told Franceline, speak in tongues every day. It's because you are fanning your fire. You are igniting your fire. You are always putting the gas, it's just like a gasoline in your life, because you are there. God, every morning, Lord God, shakaradanda kadada. Every afternoon, Lord God, shakaradanda kadado. Every evening before sleeping, shakaradanda kadado katache. Because from the moment you have this kind of sin in your heart, the devil cannot touch you at all. You are dangerous to the kingdom of darkness. That's why Elijah never asked for miracle. Elijah never asked for the people to have this kind of blessing. Elijah never even asked the rain. They never have rain for 3.5 years. Elijah asked the fire, because Elijah knows that during the time of Moses, the fire came to them to protect them. He's representing the presence of the Lord. And God said, the fire will come unto you in the New Testament. And this is even more dangerous. This is even more powerful. It's because Jesus Christ already came and died for us to give us life and have it more abundantly. And why are we going to worry? We are not supposed to worry. We are not supposed to be concerned. As long as you have the fire of the living God, you will be ablaze. God will make it sure. What God has promised to you, it will be fulfilled, because the fire, the zeal, the passion, the excitement, okay, is upon you. You have the mark of the Holy Spirit. I hope you understand. How many more minutes are today? I mean, is there some more?
30 more minutes.
30 more minutes. Hallelujah, God. Hallelujah, Lord. Thank you, Jesus, God. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord God. I hope you understand this one, because I really want you to understand that the battle is in the mountain right now. Okay? The battle is in the mountain right now. And only those people who are willing to go to the mountain of the Lord, only to those people who are willing to the mountain of the living God. Because God never gave us the spirit of fear, but God gave us the spirit of power, love, and a sound mind. We need to have this purity. Do you know that the fire will give us purity, will make us pure? And that is what God wants us to do. I don't know, I'm so emotional when it comes to purity, when it comes to holiness. Because the people of God never even understand. It is not anymore popular that we live a holy life, that we live a pure life, because there is grace available. No, the grace is available to us. God, give us grace to live a holy life. God, give us grace to live a life that is pure. God, give us grace not to lie. God, give us grace not to have this lust. God, give us grace not to be dishonest. God, give us grace to live a life
the devil with the word of God, but God, he said, the hardest thing, I'm afraid of my flesh. I cannot defeat my flesh, only the power of the Holy Spirit. I remember that he said, because you cannot defeat your flesh, only by the power of the Holy Spirit. Only by the power of the Holy Spirit. I remember it. Then he said, I am not afraid also of the devil. And I believe Joseph never afraid of the devil. But when lust came to him, when the sexy, hot Potiphar's wife came to him, he ran away. Because God wants us to run away. You need to run away. You don't fight the flesh. You fight it with your own strength, you will be defeated. You fight it by speaking in tongues. You fight it by the power of the living God. You fight it with the Holy Spirit. Because God is already giving us the tools. We cannot abuse the grace of God. And he said that this is God's will for me to be defeated, because I want you to live a victorious life. I want you to live a life that is fruitful. I want you to have your own breakthrough. That's why God said, no, don't do that. Don't do that. Obey my word. And you cannot obey it with your own strength. Run away from the flesh. You cannot obey it only by the fire of the living God. You need to ask the fire of the living God. Shekinah sinti kichisho. Hapakata shekinah kadata. Yakara sundu katapakata shende. Yakara dundu katatakata sho. Yakara sinti kichisho. Hapakata shende kichito katatakata shende kichita. Hapakata shekiri koha basheke kodente kiboha. Hapakata shende. Victory over your family. Victory over your children. Victory over your marriages. Victory over your body. No sickness will come at you, because the fire of the living God is working right now. To every person who hears my voice, in the mighty name of Jesus, God, yakara sindikite sho. Hambakata shandakata. Yakara sindikitu pakata sakata she. Yakara sindikitu tokata shikere dende. Hallelujah, God. I want the music people to come here. I don't know who is not playing the keyboard. And I want to minister today. I want us to live a holy life. This is the day of Pentecost, and this is the day that Jesus came as a fire, as the Holy Spirit. And we don't want to miss what God is doing to his people, because fire purifies us. Desire to live a holy life, desire to live a prosperous life, desire to live a life that is pleasing to him, because only by that we can sustain with all the storm that is going on around the world, with all this confusion, with all this crisis, with all this pandemic. It will not touch you, because you have the fire of the living God, not by might nor by power, but by the Spirit of the living God. And that is our secret as Christians. We don't want to live a defeated life, because God has already given us the power of the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah, God. Hallelujah, God. I want you to lay hands yourself. Lay hands yourself. Those who are watching in their hands, in their house, lay hands yourself and speaking in tongues. If you don't know how to speak in tongues, just worship the Lord. But lay hands yourself. Make yourself on fire for God. Lay hands yourself right now. Hallelujah, God. Speak to your condition. Speak to your mountain. Speak to your problem, because it's nothing compared to the fire of the living God. The fire of God is a consuming fire. It will consume every lust. It will consume every sickness. It will consume every division in the heart. It will consume every confusion. It will consume everything that is not of God. Lay your head. Speak in tongues. Speak healing to your children. Speak blessing to your children. Speak healing to your marriages. Speak healing to your body. Yakara sindikiti chukata chakata da. Hapakata sindikiti do. Hakara sindikiti chukata chakata chukata cha. Hapakata hapakata sindikiti. Yakara sindakata do. Yakara sindikiti chukata chakata chakata da. Yapakata sindikiti. Yapakata sindikiti cho. Yakara sindikiti chukata chakata cha. Hapakata sindikiti do. Yakara takata chukata da 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 da. Hallelujah, God. Thank you, Jesus, God. Hallelujah, God. Thank you, Jesus, God. Hallelujah, God. Thank you, Jesus, Lord. Come, Papa, come, Papa, come, Jesus, Lord. Come, Papa, come, Papa, come, Jesus, Lord. Hallelujah, Lord. Thank you, Jesus, God. Hallelujah, God. Thank you, God. Hallelujah, God. Young people, teenagers, you will be on fire by the living God. Single, you will be on fire.